everybody in their seats so we can get the ceremony started soon? Welcome everyone, good evening. My name is Lori Gian and I'm the director of the practical nursing program here at Diman. I'm so happy to welcome all of you, family and friends of our graduates, our distinguished guest, Mayor Paul Coogan, and also Mr. Ribello. Also faculty and staff, and of course our soon to be 2023 graduates. This is the day they've all been waiting for, I know for sure. So I'd also like to take this time to introduce the faculty who helped get the students to this point today, okay? So we have, over on the end, we have Mrs. Alexandra Nerona. She's one of our full-time instructors. Next to her, we have Mrs. Stephanie Berry. She is also one of our full-time instructors. We have Miss Cassie Medeiros, who is also a full-time instructor. Mrs. Lisa Young, who is our clinical department head. Behind them, we also have Mrs. Crystal Santos, who is our administrative support person. Next to her is Miss Rebecca Mello, who has been helping us always. She's a long-term sub here. In the other row, trying to hide, is Mrs. Rosie Blanchette, who is also our administrative assistant. So that's all our faculty that helped get the students where they are today. Before we begin our commencement exercise, I just want to have a few little announcements. Please be sure all your cell phones are turned off or on silent. This is a special night for the grads, and we don't want anybody interrupting them. Make sure when it comes time for the grads to come on stage, we welcome one family member from each grad group to come up and take pictures. We welcome you to do that when they get pinned, when they receive their diploma, but just please try and send one person from your group. Otherwise, it's going to get congested and some of the others will not be able to see well. Now, to welcome you to the ceremony, we have a video from our superintendent director, Brian Bentley. He could not be here today because he is with our Skills USA chapter and they are performing at the national level to get some goals for the school. So he sent us a short video.
Good evening. If you're watching this video, that means that you... Good evening. If you're watching this video, that means that you are sitting in the Diman High School auditorium there for tonight's LPN graduation celebration. I would like you to reflect upon everything that has been going on in your life for the past, what seems like more than a year, and how you got on this journey and where you are tonight. The hours and hours of studying, the time that you've given up to your family and your friends so that you could stay and do well in this program, it has meant a lot. It's meant a lot to you, and it's meant an awful lot to your teachers. So, what's next on this journey? Well, tonight, you're going to be crossing the stage with an LPN certificate indicating that you have made it. Why have you made it? You've made it because you have dedicated yourself to the fact that you want to put smiles on faces, give comfort to those who need it, and just basically take care of people. What a true calling. I wish you always the best. You are amazing with everything that you've done and you're going to do. You can start to recapture some of that family time that you've been missing. But most of all, take a great sense of pride in what you have done and the accomplishment. Congratulations, class of 2023. I wish you nothing but success.
Next, I am pleased to introduce and welcome to the podium the Honorable Mr. Paul Coogan, Mayor of Fall River.
I say this to everyone, I will not talk long because I know why you're here. I want to congratulate all the families, the students, the new LPN nurses that are so desperately needed in the healthcare field. I know this is a big door opener for you, and I know it's going to lead to a great and happy life. I wish you all nothing but the best, and I want to congratulate the staff at the Diman LPN program and the school. Congratulations. Let's get you across the stage and start to have some fun. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you, Mayor Coogan. At this time, I ask all of you to please stand. As we salute the flag, followed by the national anthem. And this will be sung by our full-time day student, Ruth Fortunato. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice.
stripes and bright stars through the perilous night. All the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs burned, stinging air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star sprinkle banner yet wave? All the land of the free and the
She's been practicing that for a couple of weeks now for all the class. Okay, so now it's my turn. Good evening, everyone. I am honored to be here today to speak to all of you as you graduate from our practical nursing program. Congratulations. You have all worked so hard to get to this point, and I'm so proud of each and every one of you. As a practical nurse, you have a very important role to play in the healthcare system. You will be the first point of contact for many patients, and you will be responsible for providing them with the care and support they need. This is a huge responsibility, but I know each and every one of you is up to the task. Remember, now more than ever, nurses are needed in healthcare, and you will make a difference. One of the most important things you can do as a nurse is to treat your patients with kindness and compassion. You never know what your patients are going through, and most times, you are the light at the end of a dark tunnel for them. Always smile, because it may be the only one they see that entire day. Even when days seem long and the work is hard, always remember why you entered this profession, to help and care for others. Treat every patient as how you would want your mother or father treated. Don't judge, just listen and be present at all times. Another important thing to remember is to always be willing to learn. We tell you guys that all the time. The healthcare system is constantly changing, and it's important to stay up to date on the latest development and the best practices. By continuing to learn and grow, you can provide the best possible care to your patients. Finally, I want to encourage each and every one of you to never give up on your dreams. You have all worked so hard to get to this point and have the skills and knowledge you need to make a difference wherever you choose to work. I also want to say, don't stop here. Keep climbing up that career ladder and keep advancing your skills. So my advice to you is to keep pushing forward, keep learning, and never ever give up on your dreams for yourself. On behalf of the administration, faculty, and staff, with a special thanks to Ms. Santos, I don't know what I would have done without her these last few days, we are proud to have been participants in the beginning of your journey as you enter the nursing profession. Congratulations, class of 2023. You are all going to make amazing practical nurses in our community, and I can't wait to see all the great things you will accomplish in the years to come. Good job, guys. I am proud to introduce our guest speaker tonight. She is a 2022 graduate of the Diman Practical School of Nursing, Ms. Ignatia Jewis.
graduating class of 2023. My name is Ignatia, and I graduated from Diman Regional School of Practical Nursing in 2022. I am honored to be here tonight to congratulate you all and welcome you into the profession of nursing. I'm sure you never thought this day would come. I had the privilege of starting this journey with some of you back in 2021, while I also had the pleasure of meeting others during your community rotation at WOTC. I couldn't be more proud of each and every one of you, as you have all worked so hard to get here today. You've experienced many sleepless nights as you read endless chapters, studied for exams, and prepared for your clinical and community rotations, amongst many other things. You've made sacrifices while you had to find that perfect balance between work, school, and family obligations. But despite the challenges you have faced along the way, you have all persevered. Your hard work and determination have led you down the path of success. As a new nurse, I don't have much experience to share with you, but what I can tell you is that you may not feel prepared walking into your first day of work. You may not even feel prepared 6 months later or even a year later, but don't let that discourage you. You may never even feel fully prepared, as the nursing profession is unpredictable and always changing. It is our job to adapt, improvise, and respond to the patient's needs, however they may arise. Although it can be overwhelming and challenging, it is worth every moment. As Florence Nightingale once said, "Let us never consider ourselves finished nurses. We must be learning all of our lives." The phrase "nurses are lifelong learners" has never made more sense. You will continue to learn as you go, and you will be able to spread your experience and knowledge to the next incoming nurse. Thank you all for inviting me to be a part of your celebration. Congratulations, and I wish you all the best of luck in your future endeavors. Today is the beginning of the rest of your lives. Thank you.
Thank you, Iggy. When she came in tonight, I said, "How's things going in the nursing world?" And her face was like, the reality set in. So some of you were shaking your head with sleepless nights. Have you had sleepless nights?
No.
At this time, I would like to welcome to the stage our class officers for the part-time day and full-time day, Presidents Colette Hubert for part-time day, and for full-time day, Sabrina Cordero Acevedo.
To represent the best nursing cohort a nursing student could ever imagine. I'd first like to thank the full-time class for giving me the opportunity to stand here today and speak on our behalf. I'd like to thank the teachers for the motivation, encouragement, and tough love at times to get each and every one of us across the stage today. And lastly, I would like to thank friends and family that have gathered here today as we celebrate this tremendous accomplishment in our lives. To my fellow graduates, we did it. And for some of us, we accomplished something we never imagined we could. Tonight, we stand together and celebrate our journey, surrounded by those who never stopped believing in us. Our journey started when we first received the acceptance letter. Nothing could touch us. We were nursing students. The scrubs, the name tags, and let's not forget the stethoscopes. Reality set in at orientation. We looked at each other with profuse sweating, pallor, and pupil dilation of 10 millimeters bilaterally, wondering what had we signed up for. It didn't take long for us to realize we were in the fastest and most difficult ride of our lives. It also didn't take long for us to realize that as long as we had each other to lean on when times became difficult, there was maybe a very slim chance we could pull each other through to the next term. We'd often say to each other, "Let's just try to get through this week." Even at times when we all felt like we were drowning, we still managed to find a way to grasp onto each other and keep pushing forward. After tiring days of clinical tests where all answers were right, but one answer was more right than the others, and Mrs. Young's wild lectures, we made it. We made it through 10 months of birthdays and holidays, 10 months of phone calls that lasted hours, 10 months filled with days where we couldn't stand each other, and 10 months of no sleep and never-ending nights of studying. We complained a lot about the workload, but little did we know we were slowly being molded into a professional ready to enter the healthcare field with a new title as a nurse. We thought controlling our laughter in a class full of pin drop silence was the most challenging thing to do. Little did we realize that controlling our tears on this day would be a million times harder. I've spent these last 10 months under the impression that this would be a never-ending adventure, because that's exactly how it felt like. But I am now realizing that I was wrong. It does end. But what feels like the end is often a new beginning. We never thought this day would come, even though we hoped it would come quick, crossed days off our calendars, and counted down the days, hours, minutes, and seconds. And now it's here. As I was writing this speech, I stopped here, and not because I didn't know what to say, but because I didn't know how to say it. I am beyond proud of each and every one of us. My heart is full, knowing that these are the hands that will care for my loved ones. You all have shaped my life in one way or another. We will see life and death. We will hold hands of strangers and wipe away their tears. We will laugh uncontrollably and cry behind closed doors. We are the ones that will be there from the first breaths of life to the last breaths. No matter how difficult the days may be ahead, always remember your why. No matter, never forget the reason why you became a nurse. I now understand why they say you make lifelong friends in nursing school. I've met some of the best people here. I love you guys. And to end this with a quote from Mamma Mia, may the rest of your lives be the best of your lives. Let us go out and be the change.
Into our first day of class 2 years ago as strangers, excited but unsure what to expect in this program. I don't think any of us expected how hard it would be. We didn't think it was going to be easy, but our excitement quickly turned into stress and feeling overwhelmed by all the classes we had to study for. Our anxiety would rise in every test day. After the test, we would get picking dim the lights as an answer to a test question. Then clinical started up and we became more overwhelmed and convinced our instructors were trying to kill us, especially Mrs. Young. With the amount of prep work we had to do each week, we never wanted to see another concept lab again. We lost classmates and friends early on and it hurt. Sometimes we wondered to ourselves, will I be next? And it only made us more stressed. It was tough, but this just helped us all to grow closer to one another and bond as a class. This also continued outside of school as we get together throughout the year for lunch just to unwind and to get a much needed break from school. Terms came and went and we eventually reached the end of our first year. We saw last year's class graduate and we wished that was us. But we knew we still had another year to go through before it was our turn. The second year went much like the first, filled with stress and test anxiety. But the added burnout on top of it from being here so long. And we just wanted it over with. Now we're finally here. It's finally our turn. And all the hard work and sacrifices every one of us had to make to get here has paid off. Each and every one of you should be proud. As we get ready to embark on our post-school nursing career, no matter what the future entails, I know we'll be able to get through any challenge life throws at us, as we'll always have each other to lean on. For support. We'll never have to go through any of it alone. Always remember that this bond, and use it throughout your nursing career. Always remember to support your patients and co-workers with the same caring attitude that we all share with each other. and you'll succeed no matter where you are. Kia, Beth, Susie, Belle, Kamita, Kara, Ali, Christine, Kim, Kayla, Liz, thank you. I'm honored and thankful for every one of you for being given the chance to represent you as president, do what we can to help your class succeed. School might be over now, and we may be going our separate ways soon, but we'll always be together as part of one big, close-knit family. Family that has stuck by and supported each other through all the hardships and challenges life, school and life have thrown at us over the past 2 years. Whenever one of us is going through the loss of a family member, worrying about a test or clinical grade, or simply having a bad day and felt like giving up, every one of us is there for one another. We refuse to leave anyone behind. That's what a family is, and I'm so thankful to have been able to be a part of that with all of you. The next time any of you have any feelings of self-doubt or start to think that you might not be good enough to do something, just look back and remember everything you've accomplished here. You made it through one of the hardest programs possible, and the sky's the limit. You're the strongest people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. So incredibly thankful and proud of each and every one of you. Love you all. Congratulations.
Both of those girls really showed what it meant to be the president of their classes. They were both always doing something for somebody, whether giving out cards or planning something, bringing in lots of food the last week of school. Sabrina fed us well. We had Portuguese bread and Portuguese muffins and Portuguese everything. I think the pizza was Portuguese too, wasn't it? We had fun times. Next, we're going to begin our special achievement awards. So at this time, we would like to recognize those students who achieved the top three grade averages in the full-time day and the top three grade averages in the part-time day program. So as your name is called, please come up and receive your award. We will start with full-time day. Okay, so for our third highest average in full-time day, it's Gladys Fashode. So we're just going to have you all just stay on the stage, and if anybody from the family wants to come up, you can come up to take a picture of Gladys, and the rest will join her soon. So when we're talking about the highest average, just to be clear, and everybody knows, they are these students that I'm mentioning all kept grades greater than 90. Throughout the whole program, the average remained greater than 90. That's like unheard of. That's just amazing to me. Okay, so we have the second highest average for full-time day is Jennifer Scott. You'll notice they're also wearing a blue and a yellow tassel because that's high honors. And the student with the highest average in the full-time day program throughout the past 10 months is Jennifer Ferreira. So these guys are gonna just, you can just stay up here while I announce the part-time day too, okay? It's okay, Jen. You'll be all right. Smile. You got someone trying to take pictures of you. Okay, so now for part-time day program, which they actually ran over 2 years, which was a very long 2 years for them. And I always give them credit because it is hard to see one class graduate and to know you have to go on for another year. So you guys are pretty awesome too. So for our third highest average in the part-time day group, we have Susanna Gomes. Great job to all these students. And let's give an extra round of applause. It's not an easy task what they did. This program is hard. And they kept their average high. Good job, guys. I also want to take a moment to just say that our two highest average students, Allie from part-time day and Jen from full-time day, Alexander's uniform, will also be giving you guys a wonderful gift from them as well. So that's what they're doing for our top two students. So we have the president here from Alexander's and Dale. Dale said hello. So you guys will have to touch base with Dale, but they're doing that for us as well. So if I could have Allie and Jen just get together for a picture, and if Dale, you want to take a picture of them, that would be great. Before they step off the stage, I just want to announce one more thing, that overall, the top average of both classes, from the highest average between all the students that we graduate tonight, Allie Lucio is the highest average overall. Stage. We were like working through these averages right to the very end, and I was like, oh, if somebody has a 90.44 and somebody else has like a 90.55. I'm like, kidding me. So great job, you guys. And once again, we thank Alexander's uniform. They help us with all our supplies throughout the year. And also, they were doing this special recognition for our top two students. We appreciate that. At this time, I'm going to take a moment to recognize our two outstanding vocational students for 2023. So these two students, they're outstanding vocational students. That doesn't just talk about their grades. These students have to be outstanding in a lot of different ways. These awards are chosen by the faculty. We get together, we look at all the students, and we look for students that just go above and beyond. It's the student that remains positive, that wants to help everybody in their class. They're the students that wants everybody else to succeed, not just themselves. So they were recognized in May we had the high school award night for our outstanding vocational student, and these two were recognized, but we just want them to come on up here. What they do receive for being outstanding students is they receive a check for each one of them for $430, and that's to pay for their full NCLEX exam. So if I could have Colette and Sabrina come on up to get the gifts. So it's Colette Hubert from Part-Time Day and Sabrina Cordero Acevedo from Full-Time Day. Good job, guys. Congratulations to all of you on your achievements. Great job. Now we will commence with the presentation of school pins and the diplomas. I ask that you please hold your applause until all the students have received their pins and diplomas. I know this is hard because we're so proud of them, and we are too, but we just want everybody's name to be heard and everybody to have their special time on stage. At the end, we can scream, yell, do whatever we want for them, okay? Here. Penis. We will start with the Part-Time Day graduates. And our first one is Kia Lee Bridell. Graduating with honors, Bethany Cabral. Graduating with high honors, Susanna Arujo Gomes. graduating with honors, Saray Watana Hong. I've been practicing that name for a long time. She gave me the thumbs up. I guess I did good. Graduating with high honors, Colette Huber. Graduating with honors, Kanita Keo. We have nicknames for some of you, and it's very hard for me not to say them. Graduating with honors, Kara King. Graduating with high honors, Allie Lucio. Graduating with honors, Christine Martinez. Graduating with honors, Kimberly Medeiros. Thank you. graduating with honors, Kayla Magato. Graduating with honors, Elizabeth Ann Villa. That is our Pot Time Day graduates. Let's give them a round of applause. Now for our Full Time Day graduates. Graduating with honors, Karina Ciro. Graduating with honors, Sabrina Lee Cadero Acevedo. Graduating with honors, Alyssa M. Costa. Graduating with honors, Clarissa Devlin. Graduating with high honors, Gladys Fashote. Jennifer Ferreira. Graduating with honors, Seth Daniel Floriano. Graduating with honors, Ruth Fortunat. She's also our amazing singer tonight. Graduating with honors, Amelia Amanda Johnson. Graduating with honors, Sammy Stephen Mina. Graduating with honors, Alicia Paley. Alicia, thank you. Graduating with honors, Charlotte Emanuela Pascal. graduating with honors, Melissa Perez. Graduating with honors, Serena R. Vega. Graduating with honors, Derek Bedinia. Let's give it up for our full-time day graduates. Yeah. Congratulations to all our Diman Regional Technical Institute School of Practic Nursing graduates of the 2023 class. Sabrina, in case you forgot, and the president from Part-Time Day Collect, please come up to the stage to light the nursing lamp of knowledge. And for all the graduates, please get the booklet out in front of you, turn to the very back, light your candles. We will now recite the Practical Nursing Pledge. All the graduates, please stand up. Just the graduates. Okay, I'll start and all of you say it with me, okay? Before God and those assembled here, I do solemnly pledge
to adhere to the code of ethics of the nursing profession, to cooperate with the other members of the nursing team, to carry out faithfully and to the best of my ability the instruction of the physician or the nurse who may be assigned to supervise my work. I will not do anything evil or malicious and will not knowingly give anyone a blowjob or assist in any malpractice. I will not reveal any confidential information
Great job. Welcome to the nursing profession, class. I would just like to take a moment just to say a few things regarding some donations that the classes have made. All through the year, both full-time day and part-time day have led some great fundraising opportunities, and they raised a lot of money, both classes. With that money, they were able to pay for their uniforms they're wearing tonight for the graduation and many other things. But one of the great things both classes did is they wanted to make a donation to someone in the community. So I just wanted to announce that part-time day, with all the money they raised, they are donating $150 to the Women's Center to help the women that are in need. And full-time day is donating $275 to the Ronald McDonald House. At this time, we would like to share a video the students created.
Thank you. stress. So I do the thing and get up to leave a climber and a singer's dead.
Preparations. It really went off great tonight, and I appreciate everyone's help to get us where we were. A special thanks to Mr. Nate Burns for providing the live streaming tonight and a recording of the ceremony, so you guys will be able to look back on this anytime you want. Eric Benoit, who's backstage, he's managing all the sound, the lighting, the slideshow, everything we needed from Eric back there. He's been great. Thank you, Eric. I know we could be difficult, but thank you. I want to give a special thanks for Mayor Paul Coogan for coming tonight. Thank you. And for Assistant Superintendent Principal Mr. Andrew Ribello to come here tonight and support us as well. Thank you. So at this time, we have concluded our graduation, but we want to let our students exit the auditorium first. So we will lead the students out. The instructors will lead the students out. And they're going to go back, the students are going to go back to the room we originally had them in so they could collect their things. And then they will meet their families outside. Please, no lingering in the hallway or anything like that. Security has to kind of make sure everybody's where they are at this tough time. Thank you to all the families and friends tonight for coming and supporting our graduation. Have a safe and good night.